It's September, and that means it's time to drain the plumbing from the cottages for the winter.
So I start each one of those by turning off the main shutoff valve for the water.
What takes the longest to drain is the hot water tanks in each cottage, and with a total of 9 cottages that I need to do, I don't have a whole lot of patience for this, so I have a faster method. So now I go to the kitchen sink and I turn on the cold water tap, and there's nothing coming out because we have no more water pressure. Here's my not so very good portable air compressor, and that's the key tool to making this work. And now going to the bathroom, I need to open the hot water tap on here and inject some compressed air into the hot water tank from the top. And you can inject some compressed air just by holding the end of this fitting tightly on there and squeezing a trigger, but I don't have a tripod here, so I don't have a spare hand for this. But what I do have is this homemade fitting, and that hole there fits over the end of the faucet with some rubber gaskets that I've got here, inner tube, and the nozzle plugs into this hole here. So, got my thing hooked up, and when I inject air in here, water should start flowing out of the other sink. The way that this works is as I inject air into the hot water side, that goes into the tank and it pushes the cold water down. And since the cold water is always fed in from the bottom, that forces the cold water out, and having nowhere else to go, it just comes out the cold water tap that I've opened. With compressed air injected into the hot water tank, it flows for quite a while even without me blowing more. The hot water tank is now mostly empty and air is starting to come out. Next step is ensuring that all the plumbing in the cottage is drained, and for that, I'm going to pressurize the hot water tank with compressed air. So turn this on and inject. With the hot water heater acting as a compressed air tank, I can just open the valves one by one to make sure everything is blown out. And in the shower. Now, just to be on the safe side, I'm going to disconnect the plumbing right here, so because this valve leaks a little bit, so that I don't get any water being pushed back in there. And I left this pressurized, so this is going to be messy. So now I'm pretty confident that I've got all the water out of the supply side. I just need to empty the traps in the toilet and the shower and such. And for that, I have another gadget, a toilet plunger with a hole in it. We still need to put a bit of antifreeze in all the traps because I can't get all the water out this way. And now it's on to the next one. 8 more to go.